Hi there. With this video, I'm going to give you a few pointers on how to copy jump output. What you have before you is a scatter plot along with a simple linear regression fit. Now, there are a couple ways to copy over jump output to, say, Word or, for that matter, PowerPoint. One way is to recognize that there are these gray triangles next to each level of the output. Now, I say each level because there's a hierarchy in terms of output when you use jump. In particular, at the highest level here, we have the bivariate fit of y by x, which gives us a scatter plot. And then within that, because I chose the option of fitting a linear fit, we get the linear fit. Now it's slightly indented in, which means it's at a lower level within the hierarchy. And then within the linear fit, we have various outputs like summary of fit, lack of fit, which is closed out, analysis of variance and parameter estimates. So if we, for example, want to copy only the linear fit and everything below, we would go to the gray triangle associated with the linear fit level. If I wanted to copy the scatter plot and the output below, I would go to the highest gray triangle. Let's start with the linear fit as an example of copying over. And let's say for some reason I don't want the analysis of variance. I can click the triangle and it'll close out that aspect of the output. Let's say I don't want the parameter estimates. I'm going to close that out. Now what I'm going to do is right click on that gray triangle. I'll find Edit, Copy Picture. Now let's move over into Word, and our inclination at this point might be to do a Control V or a right click paste. Let me do that. And indeed, it's copied over what I wanted. I wanted the linear fit plus summary fit. I didn't want the analysis of variance and the lack of fit and parameter estimates. It started from that point and down. However, a close look at this output would reveal that it's slightly edgy and fuzzy. The resolution's not the best. You might see that if I were to enlarge it. I don't know if you could see this with the video, but it is slightly edgy and slightly fuzzy, the letterings. So an alternative paste, which is available in all versions of Word, is not to paste regular, but to paste special. I have Word 2010. I come under Paste tab here. I find Paste Special. And the choice that I'm going to make is the recommended one of Enhanced Metafile. Now we can look at this. Let me enlarge this guy. And hopefully you can see the substantial difference between the two pastings. The one on the top, paste regular, is fuzzy. The one below is much more crisper and easier to read. So lesson one is when you're copying from jump, consider paste special. Particularly important when you're doing graphs and you really want the crispest and cleanest looking graph. I'll delete these out and let's go back to jump. Now there's a second way to copy over output. You can go to the top here where the toolbar is and choose the selection tool, which is this cross. I'm going to click that. You'll see the cursor turn from a pointer to a cross. And with this, you can basically click and choose the aspects of the output you want. So for example, suppose I want the scatter plot. Now I'm going to go ahead and click in the scatter plot, but if I want to click several aspects of the output, I'm going to have to hold down the shift key. So I'm going to hold the shift key down. I'm going to click that. That picks up the inners of the scatter plot, but it did not pick up the axes. So I'm going to click on those guys. And let's say I also want, and just to show you what we can do, let's say I want the summary of fit. here's that part of the summary fin and that part of the summary fin, and that's all I want. Let's pretend. But what we're seeing here is that we can selectively pick parts of the jump output. I'm going to do a control C for copy. I'm going to go to, let's say, Word. And again, you don't want to do a paste regular. What you want to do is a paste special. So I'll go to paste, paste special. More options are shown under this, but in the end, we still want enhanced metafile. And there we have a nice crisp copy of the pieces that we picked. Notice that when I did the copy picture, you saw the output headers like linear fit, the summary of fit. Here we only see the parts that we picked, and we only picked the graph, the axes, and the inner workings of the summary of fit output. So that's another way to copy using the selection pointer. Let me go back here and note that we're still on the selection pointer. If I right-click the selection pointer into any part of the jump output, I'm going to right-click. The option of select all comes up, which basically copies everything that we have in front of us. I can do a control C, do a paste special. And we can see that we have the scatter plot plus the linear fit plus the summary of fit, and also the output header names of linear fit, summary of fit, bivariate fit of y because of y by x, because it copied and selected everything in front of us. It did not select the things that were closed out, so those weren't shown there. So that's another way to copy. I really strongly suggest that you indeed do the paste special. Let me give you a situation where it can be quite awful looking when you do the regular paste. We saw that the copying over with regular paste is a little fuzzy. Some can live with that. But for example, let's go to graph. No, actually, let's go to analyze, modeling, time series. These variables happen to be time series. I'm going to click in the Y. And you may or may not know what we have before us, but that's not the point. It's just to show you what we can do in terms of copying. What we have here is an ACF. I'm going to close out the partial. And suppose I come up here and I select by using the selection tool the output of the ACF. I'm going to do a control C. I'm going to come over here to Word. And let me do a regular paste. My goodness, look at what I have. Nothing close to what you saw in the jump output. The regular paste basically kind of, in some sense, freaked out. If we have ever had done a paste special, we indeed have the crisp, clean, in this case, what's called an autocorrelation function, and everything's in the right place. So another emphatic reason to consider the use of paste special. One final thing that I can note is that if you are selecting output, let's just select all. You do have the option. What I've been showing you is selecting pieces or parts, copying them over, and paste specialing them into a Word document. You do have an option to select output and then go to File, Save As. And what that will do is save that aspect of the output into a file that you can give a name to, and there's various options here. There's a text option, which will not work that well considering we have a graph. There's also a PDF option. There's a Word option. So let's just choose PDF, for example. And I'm going to save that. I'm going to click OK. And you see what's been produced is a PDF of this output. I don't use this as much. I tend to copy my graphs into Word or PowerPoint using the Paste Special, and I'm always happy with that. Okay, until next time, thank you.